that. I forget this always. Yeah. Okay. I have just started recording. Now, whatever I speak will be recorded so that you can also listen to it later on. Now, there are two major things that we have to learn in the pie charts or the circular charts. One is how a given information can be put in the form of a pie chart and represented. That is the first part that you have seen in the video in the last class. Now, also, there is another variety of questions which are expected from the pie charts. You are given a data, you have learned how to put it as a pie chart. But if a pie chart is given to you, you should be able to interpret the pie chart also. Interpret means what? You should be able to get useful information. I should say useful, meaningful information from the pie charts. Then what you're doing is the interpretation of the pie charts. Now, if you have not completed drawing the pie charts by looking at the video in the previous class, please do it at least at the end of today's class. I don't see a reason as to why you were not able to draw the pie chart. Please be a little more sincere. We are not going to repeat any of this later on. So, giving you enough time to do it at your convenience, I am posting the videos. Please don't take it very lightly. You are not only simply going to view the videos like a movie that you simply see it and forget. There are certain understandings that you have to take from it, and you should develop certain skills also from every video that you see. So in the previous video, the skill that you had to develop was to draw a pie chart for any given information in the form of a data. All right. So in the hope that at least today you will go back and view the video and complete the pie chart. Now I am going on to the exercise 5.2 in your textbook. This is in page number 82. I hope you have your textbooks with you, because now we are going to look at the pie charts and try to gather information from it. All right. So for those who do not have the textbook, I'm trying to present the textbook here. Are you seeing my screen with the textbook presented there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, yeah. Ma'am, practical geometry notes where we want to write?
I didn't get you. Please come again. What is that?
Ma'am, practical geometry notes where we want to write, ma'am? I mean, rule book or unruled book, ma'am?
There's only single book, my dear, for maths. You choose it is a ruled or it is an unruled. I think I told this in the beginning when you started. I gave you a choice because I didn't want to insist that you have to write in unruled book only. But when you come to construction or when you come to graphical representation, you would have felt the need of an unruled book. So that's why you are asking this question, I can understand. But you have already started in a ruled notebook. Now don't shift to a new notebook. Just continue in the same. All right. Also, I actually, when we are face to face in the classroom, we do our construction in the record itself. I think I asked you to do it also in the record. Did I not tell you?
Yes, ma'am. You told activities in the notebook we should do.
Only you maintain, because I have the convenience of a left hand side where it is unruled, I can do the construction. And later I have the ruled side where I can write the steps of construction or the procedure. So there is no different notebook, my dear. A classwork and a practical record. So construction, for convenience, I have shifted to the practical record. Now you can come back to your classwork to continue with the pie charts. That is the data handling you should have started in your classwork only. Is the doubt clarified?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in exam only objective type question you will give.
Sorry, yeah. Come again. Come again, please. Who was speaking?
Ma'am, in exam only objective type of question will
come. Only this exam, because you're going to do it for the first time on a virtual mode, because not face to face with us. No, you're going to sit at home and write. We thought we will have it as a objective type this time. So next exam, maybe we will have the descriptive ones also. Like the 10th and the 12th are writing descriptive exams only from today. They have their exams started today already. So they are writing it in the descriptive form only. So next chance when you get, you also should get ready for that. Because we have to understand what is your connectivity status, what is the status of the device that you have, whether you can go for 2 hours and more for an exam. All this we will understand when we take up this MCQ test. Okay. Now, from all the 5 chapters that I have decided, including the data handling, I'm going to ask you objective type questions only. Objective does not mean only multiple choice. My dear children, I hope you understand that. I think I'll stop the share and come back for a while. Now, objective does not mean only multiple choice questions. It is not necessary that the choice is given every time. There may be a question where you have to work out and find out the answer, and you have to give that answer. You can't be asking for the answers, because multiple choice gives a scope for guess, which we don't want always to happen. So objective type may contain a few MCQs, but all of them need not be MCQs at all. Clear? This is very similar to the quizzes that you have been taking up. You have attended at least two quizzes until now, 2 or 3. How many have you taken up so far?
Ma'am, one.
Only one.
Ma'am, you told that I will give quiz, but you didn't give, ma'am.
Okay, maybe. Because there was some constraint with the 6th and the 8th. I was juggling between the two classes. Maybe I have done more there and less for you. Never mind. Once this data handling is over in another 1 or 2 classes, we will take up quizzes only. We will try to do it in the quiz for a few days. Then we will take it up on the Google form also. Like you did the quizzes on your mobile, you have to do the Google form in your system or your mobile by clicking on the link. So it is very similar. All right. Here also you will have MCQs, or you will have objective where you will work out, find the answer and write down the answer there. It can be a fill in the blank type. It can be a matching activity. So all this is expected. So prepare yourself for such kind of questions from all 5 chapters. Yeah.
Ma'am, you will not give practical geometry notes. You will not do that chapter. Yes.
I may not ask you to construct, because construction is not possible in the Google form or the quizzes. But there are questions which can be asked based on practical geometry. It is not that everything is practical in that. No, there are some things that I can ask in the practical geometry also as a theory question. So think about it. What is that I can ask? If you go through your textbook carefully, there are lots of information which is available, which can be asked as an objective type question in practical geometry also. So don't think that chapter is avoided anyway, practical geometry. Ma'am will not ask me any construction. Then why should I prepare for that chapter? Don't be under that impression. Please go through your textbook carefully. There is a lot of content which is available in those pages in the chapter, which may come as an MCQ. Like, for example, very quickly, I'll give you one example. How many measurements do you require to draw a specific variety of quadrilaterals? How many measurements do you think?
5 measurements. 5.
Is it 5 or 4?
Ma'am, 4.
Okay, somebody is already feeling 4. Somebody is feeling 5. See, this is a question which is totally based on your practical geometry only. And still there is no construction involved in it, because I'm just asking you a straight question. How many measurements do you think I have to give you so that you can draw a specific variety of quadrilateral?
Lavanya is waiting, ma'am. You have not admitted her.
Oh my God, why is Lavanya waiting? Oh, there are so many more waiting.
I'm 5.
Yeah, I got them. Yes, there are 5 different measurements which are absolutely required to construct a quadrilateral. A 4 may look as though it is sufficient, but it is not sufficient. The explanation for this is very much there in your textbook. So go through it. Such questions are possible even from practical geometry. All right. So I think you will be more convenient when we take up a few more quizzes in these chapters. So let me complete this data handling this week, so that next week we can conveniently take up a few quiz and we can get a feel of what kind of questions can be asked in the midterm. Okay. Now I think I'll go back to my share screen, where I am in that page of your textbook. If you have your textbook, it is well and good, because here I have to zoom and show you otherwise. Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
On page number 82.
Even if you can see the screen, it's not a big deal, because you can go and see in your textbook only. That is a more convenient way of seeing. Okay. In case you don't have the textbook, I'm just projecting. Okay, this is an exercise 5.2. We are on problem number 1. Because this is a pie chart already given to me. Can you see the circular graph on the page number 82?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So yes, we are going to understand that pie chart and try to answer the questions. So the first question, this you will write down in your classwork later on. Let me discuss it now. Then I will give you time to write it down also. All right. A survey was made to find the type of music that a certain group of young people liked in a city. So this is a survey which is conducted to find out what kind of music people like. Adjoining pie chart shows the findings of this survey. So there is a pie chart. Can you see a circular chart? Now quickly look at this chart and tell me what kind of music do you think is liked by maximum number of people?
Like music.
How did you suddenly tell this answer to me?
Ma'am, because most of the circle is covered by light music.
Yes. Can you see the area of the circle which is labeled as light music? It is 40% of the total circle. That is the biggest portion of the circle. Do you understand? That light music. Can you see it there? I'll just show it. See, this is the one. This part.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. I think I can annotate yes, also if required. Let me see. Just give me 1 minute. See, this portion is what I'm talking about. This is the 40% of the entire circle, which is the portion of people who like the light music. And which is the kind of music liked by minimum number of people?
Classical.
Yeah, how did you again suddenly tell that? Because that is the smallest portion. Can you see I'm talking about this portion? I have marked it in blue there. So that is the smallest portion. Visibly, it is clearly giving me the information that the largest portion is light music and the smallest portion of the entire circle is classical music, right? So these are some information we can quickly draw by looking at the pie chart. That's why the pie chart is a very useful way of representing or putting the data so that we get meaningful information in a very quick manner. Now let us go and see what are the questions which we have in that. So let me go there. Okay, the first question is, from this pie chart, answer the following. If 20 people liked classical music, how many young people were surveyed? So they are telling that 20 people can like classical music. So what percentage is the classical?
Ma'am,
10%.
10% of the entire 100% is classical lovers. Okay, I think this is moved away. Okay, I'm not worried about this screen sharing. Is anyone not having a textbook? Otherwise, I'll go back to the board. Do you all have your textbooks with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll stop share and then I'll come back to the board only. Let me go back to the board so that you are more conveniently looking at me more than the screen there. Now, we already have from the pie chart that 10% of the entire circle are classical music liking people. Now, the question is, if 20 people liked classical music, how many young people were surveyed? What is the total number of people who were surveyed? How will you find this? Any idea? Only percentage is given to me. That is 10% like classical, 20% like semi-classical, 40% like light music and 30% like folk music. Now, based on these percentages, I have to go and find out what is the total number of people who are surveyed. Now, classical music. People who like classical music is 20%. That's what we get from the pie chart. So 20% means it is 20 by 100 into the total number of people. Let X, suppose we don't know how many people are getting surveyed. So let X be the number of people. So these many people are getting survey, and hence we know that 20% of the total people are classical music lovers. Okay, so now that is given as 20. 20% of the total number of people is given to be equal to 20 itself. Can you understand the information given in the first part? If 20 people like classical music, okay, classical is 10%, sorry. Is the classical music liking people. Now that 10% means it is a part of the total people who are present. We don't know how many people were surveyed. The pie chart is telling me out of so many people surveyed, 40% are liking light music, 20% are liking semi-classical, 10% are liking classical, and 30% are liking folk music. Now the information given is, if 10% of the total number of people are liking classical music, the number is given to be as 20. This is the percentage and this is the actual number. So 10% of the total number of people will exactly give me the actual number of people who are liking it. Percentage in the actual number ke okay. 10% of the total number means it is equal to classical liking people, which is given as 20. Now can you see an equation form here? This will become 20 equals x divided by 10. Can you see the simple equation form here? Do you think you will be able to solve the simple equation? The division is getting transposed. The 10 is going there. So it will become 20 into 100 is equal to x, or your x is 200. That means 200 people were getting surveyed in the entire place wherever the survey is done. Out of 200, only 20 people are liking classical, because 10% of 200 is 20. That's how you confirm your answer. So in the pie chart, even if you don't know how many people are getting surveyed, if you know one of the information, that is the actual number of one portion of the pie chart, then you are in a position to go back and tell what is the total number of people who are getting surveyed. All right. So this is one information you are able to get from the pie chart. Now moving, I hope it is clear. Any doubt so far?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So we'll move on to the second one. Which type of music is liked by maximum number of people? This is very simple. I already asked this
question. Light music.
Yes, it is the light music. If a cassette company were to make 1,000 CDs, how many of each type would they make? Now, this survey is done with a purpose. It is not that simply somebody went and took the survey to find out who is liking what type of music. Now, there is a cassette company who is manufacturing CDs according to the interest of people. Now, suppose I am having a cassette company and I make CDs. So, what is that which will help me to tell which kind of music I have to prepare maximum? As a cassette company, I want to sell maximum number of cassettes. Correct? That should be my motto. If I am a person who is doing a business where I am selling cassettes, what kind of cassettes will I try maximum to sell, which is liked by maximum number of people? Is it true or not?
Yes, ma'am.
So that survey is actually made for this reason only. So if a cassette company wants to start making cassettes, he will definitely depend on the liking of the public, because the public is the consumer. He is the one who will buy. So if maximum people like something, will I make that kind of music, or will I make a cassette which is liked by minimum number of people?
Maximum number of people.
Yes, I will try to make which is liked by maximum number of people, because I want to sell my cassettes. So if I want to sell my cassettes, I have to keep the interest of maximum number of people. So here, if a cassette company were to make 1,000 CDs, how many of each type would he make? So this survey will allow me to tell how many of each type. Because in the whole population, 40% are liking light music. So now I have 1,000 cassettes which I want to make. That is, the total number is available with me. I have 1,000 cassettes in my hand. So each variety, how much will I give? Now I will tell total number of cassettes or CDs is 1,000. I can't go more than this. I can't make less than this. 1,000 is fixed, total CDs. Out of which, 40% will be allocated for light music. Why? Because 40% of the population like the light music. So I have to find out what is 40% of 1000. All right, 1000 poorthi cassette anathre ide. Adrally 40% I have to give it to light music. So how will I find the number of CDs? For I'll start from the light music because that is the maximum. So light music, because 40% is there, the liking. So 40% of, that is 40 by 100 into 1000. All this you have done in fractions and percentages in class 6. Percentage of the total. When you say, you should always write it as a fraction. This is a decimal fraction. You are converting the percentage as 400. So 40 by 100 into the total number of CDs is 1000. So how many CDs for the light music you will make? These two zeros get cancelled. 40 into 10, 400. Like this, do you think you will be able to find out how many CDs for semi-classical, how many CDs for classical, and how many for folk? Do you think you will be able to find out that individual?
Yes, ma'am.
Because the percentage is given to you, you have to convert that into a decimal fraction and multiply with the total number of CDs which are available. So this portion you should be able to complete. Once you complete that, then maybe we can move on to the next problem. Okay, could you complete that? I'm the hope that you will be able to complete. I'm skipping on to the next one. Or should I do it? You should only tell me. Can you find out like this for classical, semi-classical and the folk music? Percentage is given. Percentage into the total number will give you individual number of CDs for each kind of music. Do you think you'll be able to complete it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
I think we will move on to the second one now. I won't be discussing many problems. If I am able to discuss even another one or two problems, should be enough for the pie chart. Maybe tomorrow, do I have a class with you? Yeah, maybe. Do I have a class with you tomorrow?
Yes, ma'am.
Which is the class? It should not clash with my exam. Okay, tomorrow it is 12:20 to 1. No. Oh, tomorrow is that 2 to 2:40, is it? Wednesday.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then I'll give you some work, because at 2 to 2:40 we are not meeting physically, no? So I'll give you a little work so that you can complete that homework. Okay, now we are going on to the second one. A group of 360 people were asked to vote for their favorite season from the three seasons, that is rainy, winter and summer. So there are three seasons and you have to tell which is your favorite season. This is how the survey went on with 360 people. Now the diagram is shown there. You can see there is summer, rainy and winter. Summer number of votes were 90. For rainy it was 120 and for winter it was 150. Now it's a very straight question. Which season got the maximum votes? Which season got the maximum votes?
Season.
Yeah, winter, because the number is 150. Find the central angle for each sector. So this central angle is what we discussed in the video in the last class. Now quickly I'll try to tell you what are the three or four columns that you have to make if you have to prepare the pie chart for this information. Now this information is very simple because there are only three seasons which are present. So your tabulation should be ready, only then your pie chart can get ready, right? So we have the seasons first, and the seasons are only three varieties: the summer, the rainy and winter. All right, and here the number of votes for each of them is given as 90 votes. For the rainy you get 120.
150.
Make this column. I'll just come back. I have somebody waiting. Make this column. All right. So the next column that you have to make is the fraction. And from the fraction, you have to find the central angle. So this is what you've been trying to do in the previous video if you have watched clearly. All right. So first you will get a fraction. Then you will get central angle. Am I correct? This is what I think I have spoken in the previous video also. Okay, now to get the fraction, what you must know? You must know what is the total number here. Only then you will get summer is 90 divided by the total. So add these three, what will you get? 90, 120 and 150?
360.
Yes, 360. So the fraction of people who like summer is 90 on 360. And here it is 120 on 360. And this is 150 on 360. Then when you want the central angle, can you remember what you have done?
Yes, ma'am.
What did you do? When you want to convert the fraction to the central angle, because central angle
into 360.
How you can divide the circle into various parts? Yes, the fraction has to be multiplied with 360. So it is so simple here. The 360 in the numerator and denominator will get cancelled and you will have just 90 degrees. Similarly, here it will be 120 divided by 360 into 360. So that will give you a 120 degrees in the central angle. Then 150 divided by 360 into 360 will give you 150 degrees. So first you must have the column having the fractions. Then the fraction when it is getting converted to the central angle, you have to multiply with 360 to get the corresponding central angles. So once these central angles are obtained or you get them, then drawing the pie chart is very easy. How will you start? You will take a circle of any convenient radius, any small convenient radius. First draw the radius, one of the radius. Mark this as the center of the circle. The first angle you will take will be 90 degrees. So with your protractor, you will draw this 90 degrees and tell this is the portion for summer. You can write 90 volts there. You can box it up like that. Then the second angle that you want at the center is 120. So where will you keep your protractor? On the solid line or on the dotted lines? From here I have to get 120.
I'm on the dotted.
So now on the dotted line you will keep the protractor. This is 90, 120 will be somewhere here. Okay, this is the portion of rainy season which is like by 120. And automatically the other portion, because there are only three portions that you cut out of this entire circle, the third portion will exactly measure 150 degrees. You can confirm it. And here you can write winter, which is like by 150 feet. So this is how your pie chart should be ready. As I was telling you, you can shade it in different manners. See, I can give oblique shading for one portion. I can put some other, see, I put star marks. This is the other portion. You can use your creativity to shade it in a different way. And maybe in this one, you simply keep the dots. This is another way of segregating them. Or if you have color pencils, you can do it in different colors as you like. So this is the way in which information is gathered from a pie chart, or when it is suppose that you want to draw the pie chart for a given information, both the ways the questions you should be able to handle. Alright, so I will give you two or three more problems which you can do it in your classwork and complete. Okay, come to page number 81. Should I share it or you are looking at your textbook? So this one problem you will draw the pie chart. The first problem also you will complete, because tomorrow's session is between 2 and 2:40. It is for writing back and completing your notes. I want you to do the second problem in page number 81. Can you read what is the problem written there? You can try this. Think, discuss and
choose of food for a group of people.
Can you see?
For a group of people. South
Indian, Chinese, others. So there are four portions into which your circle will be segregated. That is the North Indian food, South Indian food, Chinese and others. Total is already given to you. So you will make the next column, which will be the fraction, which will be 30 divided by 120, 40 divided by 120, 25 divided by 120 and again 25 divided by 120. Once you have the fraction is to be multiplied with 360 degrees to give you the central angle. Why do you think every time you are multiplying with 360? Why not with 180 or 240?
From 360 is the complete angle.
Yes, because you are making portions of a complete circle, and a circle is having 360 degrees complete angle in it, we are always telling that from the total 360 degrees, this portion, that is 90 by 360, is belonging to the first part. Similarly, the fraction will tell you what portion is taken. And multiplying with 360 is converting the fraction into the central angle. Because eventually in a pie chart, we are going to represent the central angle only. Alright? So that is why we are multiplying the fraction with 360 every time to get the individual portions. Maybe one more problem also you can do. This is in page number 81 you have done. Come back to exercise 5.2, page number 83. There is one tabulation given there. Can you see? The number of students in a hostel speaking different languages is given below. Display the data in a pie chart. So here also, the languages spoken are the portions of the circle. That is Hindi, English, Marathi, Tamil, Bengali, and the total is given. So the third column, like you know, should be the fraction, which will be 40 divided by 72, 12 divided by 72, 9 divided by 72, 7 divided by 72, and 4 divided by 72. So once the fractions are ready, you know how to convert them into central angles. So how many portions of the circle will you be making? Look at the question and tell me how many portions will you cut the circle into?
Five.
Because there are five different languages which are recorded. So the five portions will be decided by whom? How will you decide how much portion is to be given for each language? Who decides the amount of portion given to a specific language? The central angle. That is why we are finding the central angle. Because the central angle will decide what portion of the circle belongs to a particular category. So that is why the central angle is very important. Clear? Do you think you'll be able to complete these problems? I've given you three problems. Question number 2 and 5 in exercise 5.2. And in page number 81, you have think, discuss and write the second one I want you to complete. So I should be able to see three pie charts ready when I meet you back on Thursday. Alright? Thursday, I have my maths exam for 10th standard. When is the class on Thursday for us? I don't know if I can definitely. No, Thursday also it is. Thursday I have it in the 12:20. No, yeah, I can join. Yeah, not a worry. Because by the time they would have almost settled down. Okay, so I'll meet you on Thursday at 12:20. Alright, the link will be sent. Please join without any delay and complete this work. I hope you have understood what you have to do. Do you have anything to ask me?
No, ma'am.
Okay, then. I think complete the work. Those who have not completed the pie charts from the previous video, please look at that also and complete the work. All right?
Okay. Ma'am, only two homework?
Three. Three questions for today and two of the previous class. Five pie charts should be ready. On the whole.
Okay. So what is the last question?
Last question is exercise 5.2, the fifth one. All right. Anything else? Okay, then. Bye. You can leave. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a nice day, ma'am.
Thank you. Have a nice day, ma'am.
Thank you.